The Spotlight, shining a light on podcasts and videos that have caught our attention.
Hi, and welcome to The Spotlight. I'm Jen Spiker, and today I have a podcast worth sharing, especially for the guys. Momentum is a Christian radio ministry created to help men find faith in Christ and fellowship, honesty, and support amongst each other. The program is heard on Vision every weekend and is available on demand in the Vision app. The hosts, Des Kennedy and Timothy Charles, discuss topics relevant to men with different guests. On a recent program, Tim and Des were joined by Brett and Kate Ryan, who lead Focus on the Family Australia, to share about the often misunderstood topic of menopause.
The Spotlight with Jen Spiker.
We kind of started unpacking then. We talked about friendship, which was a really great segue, and I think actually a really, really important thing to note to maintain the friendship throughout the marriage and through the crazy years with the kids, so that when you hit this stage in life, you're not looking at each other like complete strangers. You've still got the connection through friendship. But let's come back to your journey, Kate, if we start with you. We talked about the personal summer that you were having on a regular basis, and you guys made a bit of a joke out of that with the sweats. But tell us a bit about the journey from there and how your menopause kind of progressed through there, and what sort of other symptoms did you experience?
So it wasn't nice. I'm just going to put it out there. It wasn't good. And so, you know, if we're going to get honest, down in the ladies' private areas was extremely dry and also painful. There were days where I could barely walk and I'd just cry. So the very thought of any intimacy that way was like a big no-go because I could barely walk. And, you know, I said to Brett, oh, my goodness, is this going to be my lot in life, our lot in life? You know, it was awful. And I ended up going to see a gynecologist, and I couldn't believe her. She goes, oh, well, dear, that's kind of the age you're at, and really, you know, you're just going to have to put up with it. I can give you a little bit of cream, and we'll probably do a hysterectomy. I said, hold on a minute. First of all, that's the one part of me I don't have problems with. So, you know, maybe let's do an operation on a part of me that's not got a problem. She goes, oh, well, you probably will in the future, so let's just, no. I walked out of there so disheartened that I had no insight into what was going on. And I got into the car and I said to Brett, now what? Because she was just dreadful.
And then I suggested the second opinion.
Yes. So I ended up doing a bit of research just on the special gynecological clinic for women. And I made an appointment, you know, not with a lot of hope, but I had talked to a few women who'd been to these specialized clinics, and oh my goodness, she was amazing. And, you know, she put me on special pessary. So I just Vagifem for any men who want to talk to their wives about it, Vagifem. And because I had cracks, you know, fissures, I kept getting urinary tract infections. And so I would get one every second month. And it would last for, and that would just make everything worse. So then I had trouble urinating and in pain. I'd sit on the toilet and cry. And, you know, it was awful. And I had a girlfriend whose mother had had an operation and had a catheter. And she said she was getting urinary tract infections. So use Urofem. So it's all along the same line. And so I just take a tablet called Urofem, and the urinary tract infection stopped. Just like that. So I started with the pessaries of Vagifem, taking a tablet that was a Urofem, and, oh, my goodness, my life just changed. And there's two options. You can go cream, but, you know, that's like for women, it's just leaks, you know, so you don't like that. So a pessary you just put in at night and it's, you know, a tablet, and so it's clean and whatever. That was probably the hardest one, wasn't it?
But added to the physiological symptoms of it, you have to also acknowledge that even though we're in love and we care for each other, just the change of season means that she's not as interested in intimacy. in that form of intimacy. She wants to show her love and affection towards me, but it's just not practical. So for men to go through this and observe this, they didn't choose this. This is part, it's a natural occurrence. They're not doing something to despise you. They're not doing something to
reject you.
To reject you intentionally, although it may feel like it, because men want to be wanted and men want to be able to be connected emotionally and physically and intimately. But at this season, it wasn't practical. So I have to show grace. I have to admit it is frustrating and it can be a real tension. And you start questioning, am I loving her enough? Is it me? I'm not being a good husband. I'm not showing the care and concern that she has. But she also had to, she had to continually reinforce, it's nothing, you have done nothing wrong. You're a good husband, and I'm not saying that to, you know, blow my own trumpet. It's not easy for me, but it's not their choice. This is part of the nature of their development, and I have to show that compassion and understanding and not force her and not to make her feel guilty. But I have to say, I didn't always succeed in that.
Yeah. Sure. Well, you're human. You're human.
Exactly. Yeah. And I would say that to him. If he'd say, oh, I failed you, I'd say, what, you're human? Imagine that.
Guilty as charged.
Yeah.
But great reminder, Brett, also, I mean, because again, and thank you, Kate, for jumping in with that, because to be honest, it is. It's like we can take that as rejection as men, let's be honest. And we can get agitated with that rather than going, actually, I don't think she wants this to be happening as much as it's affecting me. Like, this is actually not even about me, really. One thing we haven't talked about was moods and hormones and that sorts of things. Kate, did that all kick in for you as well? Did you notice that there was a shift in your moodiness, your mood swings, perhaps?
I wasn't really moody. I probably could cry more easily. I wasn't angry. Like, I didn't just fly off the handle or...
Kate went through the menopausal stage a lot easier than some of her peers, her girlfriends would share their experiences. Yeah. So we're not the typical couple going through menopause.
Well,
but we also... there's the physiological changes, most definitely. But Kate didn't have the extreme mood swings that many people have or agitation. We tried to, and Kate's very good at this, choosing joy despite the circumstances. And that's been very intentional.
Wow, that's good. We're actually running out of time again on this interview, as we would. But just finally, both of you, Brett and Kate, can you give the listeners, men and women, three or four really powerful bits of advice that would help them navigate this journey?
In no priority order, I'll give it from my point of view, is that obviously I've already said showing grace and understanding, compassion. The lack of intimacy doesn't excuse a man to find other alternatives to relieve themselves. And that could be through pornography or seeing outside of infidelity in affairs, or even just emotional affairs, or even habitual masturbation. There's all those things. You can't use it as an excuse, but that's when you have to talk to your spouse about your feelings, and for the wife to be understanding about that, what she could do to help navigate this dry season.
And there are other ways to be intimate.
And I think it's important that Kate often says, this too shall pass. We'll get through this.
Yeah.
And there is light at the end of the tunnel, but it's just this intense season. And if you're doing it together, it will really certainly help. And for us with the faith, we've included God in our conversations to pray to one another, pray to Him, and we're praying together to help navigate this, for wisdom and insight and for patience and for grace.
And the more you focus on something, the worse it gets. So if we move our focus to God, and that's the same with anything in our life, we've got to bring it to God, because He carries our burdens. And for men who are on the other end of it, it's a huge burden for them to carry. But at the same time, women, it's a huge burden for them because they've done childbirth, they've got periods, they're hormonal there, and then they go to menopause, they're empty nesting, they're, you know, and so there's a whole long liturgy of things that they walk through. And so the importance of running to God, the importance of running to each other. The problem is when we're stressed and unhappy or whatever, we tend to pull away.
Mm.
We've got to make a decision to go, I'm running towards you even in this painful time.
So leaning into God
and just saying, I love you. As a wife, you need to know that your husband still loves you, because you can feel pretty unlovable and unsexy and a whole lot of other things. And you just need to know that your husband still thinks you're beautiful, even though you can be feeling, you know, like your insides are dropping out or, you know, all of that. You feel disgusting. And your wife, your husband says, I think you're beautiful and I love you.
It's powerful. Thank you for sharing. And can I just say the one thing that you did throw out there too was in the moment when you were yelling, to pick up the phone to Brett's good friend and say, he needs you. Powerful insight. And Brett, we don't have time to hear your side of that story, Brett, but what I will say off the back of that is, guys, we do need each other. Through various stages in life, we do need to keep connected. And that is the heart of Momentum, essentially, is for guys to not do life in isolation, whether it's menopause, a marriage breakup, a job loss, whatever it may be. Guys, get connected, stay connected through life. And I will point you back to the care line, which I did jokingly do at the beginning of the show, 1-800-000-636. That number is there for you guys. Whatever is happening in your life, do not feel like there is no one you can talk to.
On the Spotlight, we've been listening to Tim and Des from Momentum with part of a recent conversation with Brett and Kate Ryan talking about menopause. It's good to hear Brett and Kate's transparency about how they navigated this season of life. To hear the full conversation, tap the podcast tab in the free Vision app and search the Momentum feed for the episode with Brett and Kate Ryan. By the way, you'll find some helpful articles and resources on menopause at the Focus on the Family Australia website, families.org.au. My name is Jen Spiker, and I look forward to sharing another podcast or video worth highlighting next time on The Spotlight.
For more great podcasts and videos like the one featured today, check out vision.org.au or the free Vision app.